Lord of both the earth and sky, who knows all the answers to where, what, and why, there is only one God. La ilaha illallah. There is only one God. La ilaha illallah. Lord of both the earth and sky, who knows all the answers to where, what, and why, there is only one God. La ilaha illallah.
Assalamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Welcome back to the best of stories from the Quran. And we're still talking about the tactics, the deception of Satan to Adam and his offspring. He revealed it in the Quran. Allah he told Allah about it, and Allah of course knows it, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed it to us in the Quran, what Satan will do. Before the break, we named six things that Satan wants us to do. The top of the list is shirk, kufr. There is a beautiful hadith, الحديث في مسلم للإمام أحمد حديث صبرة ابن أبي الفاكه رضي الله عنه قال صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said إن الشيطان قعد لابن آدم بأطرقه اللي هي لأقعدن لهم صراطك المستقيم شيطان is sitting in any path any road to goodness to the son of Adam any time that you want to do something good شيطان is sitting in the way to you He's going to stop you. He does not want you to do it at all. Look, Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said the first, قَعَدَ لَهُ فِي طَرِيقِ الْإِسْلَامِ What that means? A non-Muslim who wants to become a Muslim. Shaitan will go after this person. And look how Shaitan will actually try to convince him not to be a Muslim. Shaitan will tell him what? يَقُولُ لَهُ فَيَقُولُ لَهُ أَتُسْلِمْ Look how Shaitan... Allah, لعنه الله. May Allah curse him. That's. أتسلم وتذر دينك ودين آبائك وآباء أبيك ودين آبائك وآباء أبيك. Are you going to leave the religion of your fathers? Come on, somebody from the West, like from America or from Europe or something, huh? Come on. You're going to leave the way of your fathers and you become like these Arabs, like these people in the Middle East. You, come on. Look, he brings in the picture who? The fathers. And we know that we carry on in our hearts that love for our ancestors, our fathers. Then the person will disappoint him. And this is, by the way, the biggest disappointment for Satan, that you become a Muslim. Because then he loses a lot. Why? Because if you say La ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasulullah, you will go to Jannah one day. This is the creed of the Muslims. Man qala La ilaha illallah, just for saying it. Hadith al-Shafa'ah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will say the angels interceded, the righteous interceded, the prophets and the messengers interceded. What is left is my intercession. Hadith Anas. Take out of the hellfire a person who did not do any goodness, but he said, La ilaha illallah, Muhammadur Rasulullah. So, you see, Satan will stay in the hellfire for eternity, for eternity. He is not going to come out. The fact that you become a Muslim, you say, Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah, wa ashhadu anna Muhammadur Rasulullah, that means even if you fail to implement La ilaha illallah, the application of La ilaha illallah, you're going to be taken out of the hellfire. وَالْعَيَادُ بِاللَّهِ اللَّهِ سُبْحَانَهُ وَتَعَالَى make us all amongst those who go to Jannah without reckoning and punishment. But you will be taken out. So he loses in this area. Does he alone? Number two, he wants you to commit major sins. Major sins. If you become, number two is the sunnah, the bid'ah. If you pass and you become a Muslim, you say, أَشْهَدُ أَلَّا إِلَّهَ اللَّهِ Then he takes you to the people who follow the bid'ah. Why? Because the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that مَنْ أَحْدَثَ فِي أَمْرِنَا هَذَا حديث عائشة في صحيح البخاري ومسلم different wording مَنْ أَحْدَثَ فِي أَمْرِنَا هَذَا مَا لَيْسَ مِنْهُ فَهُوَ رَدْ صحيح مسلم مَنْ عَمِلَ عَمَلًا لَيْسَ عَلَيْهِ أَمْرُنَا فَهُوَ رَدْ You see, a lot of Muslims these days, because they don't follow the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, they end doing a lot of deeds, but it's not accepted. Why? Because there are two conditions for the deed to be accepted. Condition number one is sincerity, that you do it for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You're not doing it for showing off. Condition number two, if it is a ritualistic act, it must be done according to the sunnah of the Prophet ﷺ. صَلُّوا كَمَا رَأَيْتُمُونِي أُصَلِّي خُذُوا عَنِّي مَنَاسِكَكُمْ وَهَكَذَا. Pray like you see me praying, take your rituals from me, وَهَكَذَا. And on. So, brothers and sisters in Islam, if you pass, become a Muslim, he then will take you to a bid'ah. People who do bid'ah, dancing around and doing things not according to the Quran and the sunnah, not according to the sunnah of the Prophet ﷺ, in all your deeds to be not accepted. Because what you need deeds. Your deeds are not going to be accepted. Then comes in, after that, major sins. If you pass, you're a Muslim. You say, Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah, Ashhadu anna Muhammad Rasulullah. You follow the Quran and the Sunnah. Does he leave you? No. You follow the Sunnah of the Prophet, does he leave you? No. Come to the major sins. Women, men, adultery. زُيِّنَ لِلنَّاسِ حُبُّ الشَّهَوَاتِ مِنَ النِّسَاءِ وَالْبَنِينَ وَالْقَنَاطِيرِ الْمُقَنْطَرَةِ مِنَ الذَّهَبِ وَالْفِضَّةِ وَالْخَيْلِ الْمُسَوَّمَةِ. If you love money, craving for money, come take a loan from the bank, riba, pay riba. Women, commit adultery. Children, do what, and on and on and on. So he will take you to a major sin. Lying is a major sin. Cheating is a major sin. False testimony is a major sin. Fleeing from the battlefield is a major sin. Sorcery is a major sin, and on and on. Slandering is a major sin. Backbiting is a major sin. How many Muslims are engaged in backbiting and slandering other Muslims? Is a major sin. He will not leave you. So disbelief, then bid'ah, then major sin. If you are a Muslim, say Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah, Ashhadu anna Muhammad Rasulullah. If you're following the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and if you're staying away from the major sins, the big ones. Will he leave you alone? No, he will take you to the minor sins. This is little stuff, come on, that's okay. And Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, fi hadith fi Muslim, Imam Ahmad, he warned you, إِيَّاكُمْ وَمُحَقَّرَاتِ الذُّنُوبِ. Be aware of belittling the sins. فَإِنَّهُنَّ يَجْتَمِعْنَ. Because they will gather. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, actually in this hadith, Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, actually in this hadith, giving a very good example. Like you go to the desert and you want to cook something. And this is, what do? You want to make a fire. So you go collect straws from here, one piece from here, one piece, and you make a big fire. Imagine these little straws, little pieces, sticks of wood that you collected. Imagine them to be minor sins. فَإِنَّهُنَّ يَجْتَمِعْنَ عَلَى الْعَبِ. You make a big fire out of it. You keep saying that this sin is okay, this sin is okay, this sin is okay, this sin is okay. And at the end you end up, what? Ruined and destroyed because, and actually is a sign. A sign of hypocrisy and a sign of disobedience that you belittle your sins. في صحيح البخاري عبد الله بن مسعود رضي الله عنه, he said that المؤمن, a believer, will see his sins even if it is little, even if it is little, like a mountain about to fall on him. But a fasiq or a munafiq, a hypocrite or a fasiq, will see his sins regardless of what it is, like a fly that flies over like this, and then he does like this, like he does. So number one, لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله. You do it, he's not going to leave you. Satan is not going to leave you. Sunnah, bid'ah, he's not going to leave you. He's not going to leave you. Then what? Major, is he going to leave you? No. Minor, if you do not do the minor sin, will he leave you? No. No. He will get you in the area of al-mubahat, the things that we are allowed to do. They are not haram to do, but they will consume our time. We know that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told us in hadith Abdullah ibn Abbas, in Sahih al-Bukhari, at the book of Riqaq, the beginning of the book of the Riqaq, that the capital of the man is his time. نِعْمَتَانِ مَغْبُونٌ فِيهِمَا كَثِيرٌ مِّنَ النَّاسِ الصِّحَّةُ وَالْفَرَاغِ. Now, Satan, if you are a Muslim, saying لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله, and you're staying away from the bid'ah, and you're implementing the sunnah, and you're staying away from the major sins, and you're, alhamdulillah, not committing them, and you're staying away from the minor sins, he will occupy your time. And how many brothers and sisters we find them in a coffee shop, and they are talking and chatting. What are you doing, my brother? I'm wasting some time. Ya akhi, the time is your capital. I still remember these days in the past when we used to go, some people, they used to go fishing for the whole day, and they end up fishing 3, 4, 5 fish. And then at the end of the day, they throw it back in the water. What do you mean? I mean, if you fish, go ahead and eat it. And then you ask the person, why were you doing this? I'm wasting time. I wanted to. I understand there is a reflection and there is contemplation and all these beautiful things, but the time is the capital of the human being. After that, brothers and sisters in Islam, if you pass in this area, Satan is after you in the area of what? Doing things that are lesser in reward than other things. Like, for example, in Ramadan, reciting the Quran is a ibadah that is so shahru Ramadan alladhi unzila fihi al-Quran, the month of Ramadan in which the Quran was revealed. Then he would make you occupied with other things than this. So he would take you from al-fadl, from al-fadl to al-mafdul, something that is good to something that is less. Brothers and sisters in Islam, this is the agenda of Satan. And as I told you, he does not come to you straight telling you that I want you to be a kafir. No, he probably will take you to the area of the allowed, then the area of minors, then the area of the majors, then the bid'ah, and then to the kufr, then to the disbelief. That's his tack. And by the way, he's so patient and he's so smart. Remember, generations of Adams, of the offspring of Adam, we come and die, and Satan's still alive. He does not die. He has already got a lot of experience. So you have to be very careful. And I tell you something, the best way to combat Satan is to follow the Quran and the Sunnah. And do not compromise any of these commands. You will find out that inshallah, and with the will and the help and the support and the guidance of Allah, you are successful in combating that sworn enemy of ours, Satan. Brothers and sisters in Islam, let's find out the next episode of the best of stories from the Quran, how Satan implemented his tactics against our father, Adam alayhi salam, in Jannah. Till then, assalamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
There is only one God, La ilaha illallah. Lord above the earth and sky, who knows all the answers to where, what and why. There is only one God, La ilaha illallah. I've seen the perfection of all creation in every creature and leaf. And I don't understand any woman or man who denies the one true belief. There is only one God, La ilaha illallah.